Hi, hello mga katropa. Andito na naman po tayo sa ating Criminology Gabay Kaalaman. Again, this is your Criminology Coach, Coach Ed Montalba. Okay? Guys, I hope you are doing well at the moment. I hope okay lang po kayo. And I also hope na may natutunan po kayo sa mga previous videos na ina-upload po natin dito sa YouTube at saka doon po sa FB page po natin. Our very topic for the day, I will again bring you to the world of fingerprint. But particularly, let us try to discuss in the most simple way. Okay? I-simplify po natin yung tinatawag po natin na fingerprint classification. Yung mga computation, no? Yung sinasabi nyo pong computation doon sa fingerprint. You know what, guys? Hindi po kailangan na magaling po kayo sa math para po matutunan nyo yung fingerprint classification. Again, as promised, I will try to do my best to simplify the fingerprint classification po. But guys, before I will proceed with the fingerprint classification, is shout out ko muna yung mga estudyante ko po sa Northeastern Mindanao Colleges or NEMCO. At saka po sa estudyante ko rin po sa Southway College of Technology or Socotec. At saka po sa Andres Soriano College po in Bisig City. At saka sa lahat po ng mga criminology students in different schools throughout the country. Guys, I hope you will continue and pursue your dreams of becoming a registered criminologist. Just keep safe. Ingat po kayo lagi. Okay? So ngayon, before we will proceed to the classification proper, kailangan po natin i-review yung different types of a fingerprint pattern. Why? Because you will be having some kind of difficulty in proceeding to fingerprint classification without knowing first the different types of a fingerprint pattern and its symbols. Importante po na alam natin kung ano-ano po yung mga fingerprint patterns at saka yung mga symbols po nila. There are three large groups of a fingerprint pattern po. Diba? May tatlo po tayong large groups of a fingerprint pattern. May tinatawag po tayong arches or arch. May tinatawag po tayong loops. Okay? May loops. At saka, may tinatawag din po tayong patterns under the whorls type of a fingerprint pattern po. So ngayon, we will try to know what are those fingerprint patterns under arches. Dalawa po yan, di ba? You have the so-called plain arch and may tinatawag din po tayong tented arch. Okay? So dalawa po under arch or arches. The plain arch at saka si tented arch. Okay? Under loops, dalawa din po yung nasa loops, di po ba? May tinatawag po tayong radial loop at saka may tinatawag po tayong ulnar loop. Sa whorl po, may apat po tayong patterns. What are they? May tinatawag po tayong plain whorl, central pocket loop, okay? May tinatawag po tayong double loop, at saka, may tinatawag din po tayong accidental whorl. Okay? So, apat po. What is the symbol for the plain arch? The symbol is, of course, A. Okay? For the tented arch, the symbol is T. For the radial loop, the symbol is R. And of course, for the ulnar loop, the symbol is U. And then, for the plain whorl, the symbol is W. For the central pocket loop, the symbol is C. For the double loop, is letter D. Sa accidental po, hindi po letter A because nagamit na po natin si A doon po sa plain arch. Ang symbol po ng accidental whorl is X. Okay? So ito po yung mga symbols nila. In other words, the different fingerprint symbols are, sorry, are A, T, R, U, W, C, D, X. So ngayon, again, please tandaan po natin kung ano-ano po yung mga patterns na nandoon in every large groups of a fingerprint pattern. And of course, do not forget the symbol of every fingerprint pattern po. Guys, the fingerprint classification that our country is adopting, we are adopting the Henry system of fingerprint classification with FBI modification. Okay? So, minumodify kasi ni FBI yung Henry system of classification, and that is actually what we are adopting in the Philippines po. Okay? Now, the very purpose of that fingerprint classification is for sorting and filing purposes po. Okay? But of course, I believe that with the advent of that AFIS or computerized fingerprint system or mga with the advent of that computers, then probably the fingerprint classification is no longer applicable. But at anyhow, in the study of fingerprint, it is important that we should know on how to classify a fingerprint pattern po. So ngayon, dapat alam po natin before you will proceed with the classification proper, dapat po alam nyo po yung tinatawag po nating classification formula. Yung arrangement po ng classification. Okay? So this is actually the classification formula. Okay? May tinatawag po tayong primary classification. May tinatawag po tayong secondary classification. May tinatawag po tayong sub-secondary classification. May tinatawag po tayong major division. May tinatawag po tayong key division or classification. At saka may tinatawag po tayong final classification. Guys, this is what we call a classification formula. Importante po to para alam nyo po kung saan ilagay si primary, saan po ilagay si secondary classification, and so on and so forth. Remember, in the past or previous board exam, may mga tanong dito, no? Paminsan-minsan po, ang tanong is simple lang. What do you call that classification that can be found in between the major division and the secondary classification? Major division at saka secondary classification. Of course, the answer there is of course the primary classification. Minsan din, ang tanong, what do you call that fingerprint classification that can be found at the extreme left of the fingerprint formula? Yung pinakakaliwa po. So of course, our answer there is the key classification. Okay? Guys, this line, ang tawag po natin dyan is classification line. Okay? Tandaan nyo kasi importante yan mamaya. No, this is what we call a classification line. So guys, baka nalilito po kayo, no? Kung ano po yung i-classify po natin dito sa fingerprint classification. Tandaan po natin, importante dito na nakunan mo na ng fingerprint yung isang tao at saka yung fingerprint niya nakalagay na po doon sa fingerprint card. Okay? Kasi kailangan mo yung fingerprint card na na-fill out na ng different print coming from sa finger or fingers ng isang tao po. Okay? So, i-illustrate ko muna, i-draw ko muna si fingerprint card. Tama o ba? Si fingerprint card po, kung nakita nyo na po si fingerprint card, parang ganito po yan, di ba? Okay. There are 10 boxes po. Okay? There are 10 boxes. Okay? The upper boxes and the lower boxes. Ito po, these 5 boxes at the upper portion of the fingerprint card, these 5 boxes are intended for the fingers in the right hand. At saka, the other five boxes at the lower portion of the fingerprint card, these boxes are intended for the fingers in the left hand. Okay. So ang tawag po natin sa mga fingerprint na nakalagay dito po, ang tawag po natin dyan is ruled impression. Okay? That is a ruled impression kasi nirule po yung finger. Okay? Ang pinaka-purpose kasi niyan, makuha or makapture yung buong fingerprint ng isang tao, kaya nga nirule. Okay? So ang tawag po yung mga fingerprint na nandito is ruled impression po. So ang tawag po natin sa yung impression na nasa pinaka baba po is plain impression. In fingerprint classification, ang pinaka-importante po natin is not the plain impression but yung mga fingerprint po na nasa loob ng boxes. Okay? Kasi ang gagawin po, before you will proceed with the fingerprint classification, the first thing that you have to do before classifying the fingerprint is you will do blacking out. Ano po yung blacking out? Blacking out po, that is identifying what specific pattern po ang nandyan in every box. All you have to do in blacking out is to identify and write the symbol of the pattern appearing in every box. So blacking out po dyan, yung nag-identify ka kung anong pattern na nandyan. Diba? Say for example, this is world, nilagyan mo ng W. This is central packet loop, nilagyan mo ng C. Okay? This is regional loop, nilagyan mo na ng R. Ang tawag po natin dyan is blacking out. So that is the first thing that you have to do before proceeding to a fingerprint classification po. Okay? So ngayon, let us now try to explain on how to get the primary classification. So, what is a primary classification? Allow me to define it first. A primary classification, guys, that is a sum total of all numerical value of the world type of pattern and its composites. The sum total of the numerical value of the world type of patterns and its composites plus whatsoever the total plus 1. Para maintindihan po natin yung definition po ng primary classification, i-illustrate po natin kung paano kukunin si primary classification. Okay? Now, again, what is that line again? Doon sa classification formula natin, ang tawag po natin dyan is classification line. Diba? Yung primary classification po natin. Ito po ang kukunin natin ngayon. Okay? Guys, sa math po, may tinatawag po tayong numerator at saka denominator. Tama ho ba? The upper portion of this line, ang tawag po natin dyan is numerator. Tama ho ba? The lower portion of this classification line, ang tawag po natin dito, yung nakalagay dito, yan po ang tawag natin ay denominator. Okay? Now, this is numerator, sa baba po is denominator. Now, for the purposes of getting primary classification, para lang po sa primary classification po, ang ilagay po natin as numerator is the sum total of the numerical value of the even fingers. Okay? Ano po ang ilagay natin? Ang suma total ng numerical value ng even fingers. So ito pala, for numerator, ang ilagay natin dito, yung, ano po? Yung suma total ng numerical value of the even fingers. That will become your numerator. Ano po si even fingers? So balik po tayo dito sa ating fingerprint card po. Okay? As what I have said just a while ago, na these boxes located at the upper portion of the fingerprint card, this is intended for the fingers in our right hand. Okay? Yung mga fingers po. Ito po, this first box, dito po si finger number 1. Ito po for finger number 2. dito po for finger number 3, finger number 4, finger number 5. Ano po si finger number 1? Si finger number 1, that refers to right thumb. Finger number 2 is the right index. Finger number 3, right middle. Finger number 4, that is right ring. And of course, finger number 5 is the right little finger. Okay? So in other words, pagdating po natin dito sa lower portion, okay? This first box po, that is finger number 6. Ito pong left thumb po natin. Then this box, ito po si finger number 6, ito si left thumb. Of course, si finger number 7 po refers to the left index. Okay? Of course, this one, finger number 8 is left middle. This one, finger number 9 is left ring. And finger number 10, this is left little finger. In other words, these two boxes, the upper and the lower, this is for the thumb, the right thumb and the left thumb. This one, this is for the index fingers, finger number 2 and finger number 7. Okay, and so on and so forth. Ngayon guys, ang ilagay po natin as numerator is the sum total of the numerical value of the even fingers. Ano po yung mga even fingers? Even, meaning, the mga finger po, yung number niya is buo. Diba? Example, finger number 2, finger number 4. Diba buo po yan? Finger number 6, finger number 8, finger number 10. Sila po ang even fingers natin. In other words, all you have to do is to add the numerical value of finger number 2 plus numerical value of finger number 4 plus numerical value of finger number 6, numerical value of finger number 8, and numerical value of finger number 10. And whatsoever the total of that numerical value, you have to add one, and then that will become your primary classification in the numerator side po. Now, of course, yung denominator po natin are add fingers. The sum total of the numerical value of the add fingers. Okay, finger number 1 plus finger number 3, 5, 7, 9. These are add fingers. Therefore, ang ilagay po natin dyan muna para maintindihan po natin, para matandaan po natin, add fingers. Upper portion for the even fingers, lower portion, add fingers. Ngayon, we keep on talking about numerical value. May nakikita na ba tayong numerical value? Wala pa po. Now, finger number 1 and finger number 2, it has a numerical value of 16. Pariha po silang dalawa, 16. Finger number 3 at saka finger number 4, the numerical value is 8. Finger number 5 at saka finger number 6, the numerical value is 4. And finger number 7 and finger number 8, the numerical value is 2. And finally, finger number 9 and finger number 10, the numerical value is 1. Okay? So ito po yung mga numerical value. Okay? Yung nakalagay po na number sa itaas po, yan po ang numerical value. That is a pre-assigned value. Okay? Andyan na po yan. Fix yan under the Henry system of classification. Hindi po ako ang naglagay ng mga or nag-assign ng mga numerical value there. Okay, that is a pre-assigned numerical value in accordance with the Henry system of classification. So kailangan po na ma-memorize natin yung numerical value in every finger. Pero madali lang pong i-memorize yan. Di ba? Ang importante lang, alam mo yung 16. And then, reduce half in every two fingers. Di ba? You have to reduce half. 16, dalawang finger. Then the next two fingers, what is half of 16? 8. That is why finger number 3 and finger number 4, 8. The next two fingers, finger number 5 at saka finger number 6, you have to reduce 8 by half. Then that is 4, di ba? Ang half po ng 8 is 4. That is why 4. Half ng 4 is 2. Half ng 2 is 1. Okay? So madali lang po i-memorize yung numerical value. So ano po ang gagawin natin sa primary classification? Well, as what earlier defined, ang sabi po natin, you have to add the numerical value of the fingers, but only the world type of pattern. What does it mean? Meaning to say, you can only make use of this numerical value if the pattern appearing in these boxes are world type of pattern. Uulitin ko po no para klaro. Magagamit nyo lang po si numerical value if ang pattern po na nandito sa bawat box is a world type of pattern. In other words, pag hindi po siya world, then you cannot make use of this numerical value, then the numerical value of that non-world is zero. Zero po, wala po siyang numerical value. Okay? So ngayon, that is why, sabi ko po kanina, importante po na na-block out nyo po, meaning na nakalagay na po yung mga symbols ng fingerprint pattern doon po sa box. So ngayon, mag-sample po tayo. Okay, para i-illustrate natin ng maigi or ma-i-illustrate natin ng maigi yung sinasabi po natin na numerical value in as far as the primary classification is concerned. Pagpalagay po natin yung finger number 1, this is Regia loop. Finger number 2, this is a plain world. Finger number 3, ulnar loop. I hope klaro po, no? So finger number 4, ipagpalagay po natin, this is tinted arc. Finger number 5, this is a plain world, and that is also a plain world. Finger number 7, this is radial, this is tinted arc, this is a plain world, and a tinted arc. So, let us assume na ito po yung mga pattern na nandyan in every box po. Let us now try to compute the primary classification. So again, importante po, alam nyo yung mga finger or fingers na naka-assign doon sa numerator at saka ano po yung mga fingers na nandoon sa denominator. Okay? So ngayon, i-add muna natin, uunahin muna natin si even fingers kasi siya po ang nasa taas. Okay? Uunahin natin. So ano po yung mga even fingers? Finger number 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So ito ang unahin natin, finger number 2. Finger number 2, it has a numerical value of 16. Can we make use of the 16 as a numerical value? Magamit po ba natin si 16? To answer that, i-check natin kung world ba. If it is a world, then magamit natin yan. It is a world, tama o ba? So 16. Okay, next. I-add natin si finger number 2. The next even finger there is finger number 4. So i-add natin si finger number 4. The numerical value of finger number 4 is 8. But tanong, can we make use of this 8? I-check natin kung world ba. It's not world. It's tinted arc. Therefore, we cannot make use of this. As what I have said, when it is a non-world type of pattern, then the numerical value is 0. So, wala po. So, next, i-add po natin si finger number 4 doon sa finger number 6. Diba? Kasi even po sila eh. So, finger number 6, it has a numerical value of 4. Magamit ba natin si 4? Check natin. If world ba? Uy, world. So therefore, magamit po natin si 4. So plus 4. After finger number 6, what finger ang i-add po natin? What is the next even finger? Of course, finger number 8. Finger number 8, it has a numerical value of 2. Magamit ba si 2? Answer is no. Bakit po? Hindi po siya world. Tinted arch po siya. Therefore, plus 0. Okay? Ngayon, after finger number 8, you will proceed to finger number 10. Finger number 10 is tinted arch. It has a numerical value of 1. Magamit ba si 1? Answer, again, is no. Because this is not a world type of pattern. So, plus 0. So, ang gagawin nyo po ngayon, you have to add it. Finger number 2 plus finger number 4 plus finger number 6 plus finger number 8 plus finger number 10. I-add natin. 16 plus 0 equals 16 plus 4 equals 20 plus 0 equals 20. 20. Pero ang sabi ko po kanina, whatsoever the total, you have to add it with 1. In other words, your primary classification for the numerator po is 21. Therefore, ang ilagay po natin dito sa primary classification nyo po at the upper portion is 21. Based on this fingerprint pattern na nandito po. Ngayon, wait, let's proceed na doon sa denominator po natin. Ano po yung mga denominator? Add fingers. Finger number 1, 3, 5, 7, and finger number 9. So we will get the numerical value and we have to add that one when it is a word type of pattern. Okay? So this is finger number 1. It has a numerical value of 16. But definitely we cannot make use of the 16. Why? Simply because the pattern that appearing or that appeared in finger number 1 is a non-word type of pattern. It is a radial loop. So we cannot make use of that 16. Okay? Iris ko po to. Therefore, 0 po. Okay? Plus, finger number 3. Add tayo eh. So, finger number 3. Finger number 3, it has a numerical value of 8. Magamit ba natin sa 8? Answer is no. Why? Kasi po, ulnar po. Okay? So, plus 0. Now, let's proceed to finger number 5. Finger number 5, it has a numerical value of 4. Magamit ba si 4? I-check natin kung whirl ba. It is a whirl type of pattern. Based on this example. Therefore, si numerical value 4, magamit po natin. Next, after finger number 5, proceed tayo sa finger number 7. Finger number 7, it has a numerical value of 2. But again, we cannot make use of this numerical value 2. Why? Because the pattern in our example is radial loop. So, plus 0 tayo. And finally po, the next add finger there is finger number 9. Finger number 9, it has a numerical value of 1. Since this is a whirl type of pattern, kasi whirl po yan, so magamit natin yan. So we have to add that one with 1. So, itotal na natin yan ngayon. Remember, whatsoever the total, you have to add 1. Okay? Why? Because that is the rule of the thumb. Whatsoever the total, you should always add 1. Yun po ang sinasabi ni Henry system of classification na you have to add 1 always in whatsoever the total that will come out in the primary classification po. So, 0, 0, 4 plus 0 plus 1 equals 5. Plus 1, automatic yan, so the total now is 6. Therefore, your primary classification for the denominator is 6. Therefore, yung primary classification nyo po based on this example is 21 over 6. Yan na po ang primary classification nyo. Di ba madali lang po? Okay? Medyo complicated ng konti. Pero kung pakikinggan mo ng maigi, and if you will try to open your mind, then madali lang po. Isang example pa po para talagang ma-master natin yung primary classification. Try po natin to get the primary classification po based po sa natutunan natin just a while ago. Okay? So, i-try po natin. Sabayan nyo po ako. Okay? So, ang unang gagawin po natin, we will get the primary classification for the numerator. Ano po yung numerator? Finger number 2, 4, 6, 8, at saka 10. Okay? Siya po ang 4 the numerator. And of course, the denominator po natin, yung add fingers, pa 1, 3, 5, 7, and saka finger number 9. Of course, ang uunahin natin, yung nasa taas po, yung numerator po. I-add natin, yung numerical value po. Finger number 2, 16. Of course, this value cannot be used because this is a radial loop. So, 0 po tayo. Next, let's proceed to finger number 4. Your finger number 4, it has a numerical value of 8. Question, magagamit po ba natin si 8? The answer is, if it is a whirl type of pattern, then magamit po natin. I-check natin. Is it a whirl? The answer, probably your answer, no. That is a central pocket loop. But guys, remember kanina po, all composites of world, yung mga pattern or mga patterns na under the world type of pattern, may value yun, may numerical value yun. Remember, the patterns under world type of pattern, apat po yun. Diba? Si plain world, si central packet loop, si double loop, at saka si accidental. Ibig sabihin po, yung apat po na patterns are world. Therefore, may numerical value po yan. Therefore, since this is a central packet loop, then we can make use of this 8 because central packet loop is a world type of pattern. Okay? So, 8. Next, let's proceed to finger number 6. Finger number 6, 4 po yung numerical value niya. I-check natin. Uy, it is a world. Therefore, magamit po natin si 4. And next is finger number 8. Finger number 8, it has a numerical value of 2. Question, magamit ba natin si 2? I-check natin. Is it a world? The answer is yes. Accidental. Di ba world po si accidental? Therefore, plus 2 po tayo. Okay? Next, after finger number 8, punta po tayo sa finger number 10. Finger number 10, numerical value 1. Since this is tinted arch, we cannot make use of that 1, that is 0. So, i-add po natin lahat. 0, 8, plus 4 equals 12. Plus 2, 14. Plus 0 equals 14. Plus 1, di ba? Always add 1, the answer is 15. So, you have now the numerator 15 as your primary classification for the numerator sign. Pero hindi pa po tayo tapos, di ba? Kailangan pa po natin kukunin si primary classification sa denominator po. Saan po kukunin si denominator? Add fingers. Finger number 1, 16, but hindi po natin magamit si 16 kasi tinted arch po siya. 0. Ano pong finger ang i-plus po natin or i-add natin sa finger number 1? Add, no? So, finger number 3. Si finger number 3, it has a numerical value of 8. Magagamit po natin kasi world po siya. So, plus 8. Okay? Next, after finger number 3, you have to add that one with finger number 5. Finger number 5 is a plain arch. Of course, we cannot make use of that numerical value. And after that, let's proceed to finger number 7. Finger number 7, it has a numerical value of 2. Check natin, magagamit po ba natin si numerical value 2? The answer is yes, because double loop is a world. Okay? Membro po siya ng world family. Therefore, that 2 magagamit po natin simply because that is double loop. And double loop is a world. Let's proceed to finger number 9 po. Finger number 9, it has a numerical value of 1, but that is arch. We cannot make use of that numerical value. So therefore, 0 po. So i-add na natin ngayon. 8 plus 2 equals 10. The rule of the thumb is, whatsoever the total, you have to add that 1 with 1. So you have now 11. Therefore, yung primary classification nyo po for the denominator side is 11. Ito na po yung primary classification niyo. Di ba guys, madali lang po. Diba? Napakadali lang po ng primary classification. Okay? So ngayon, let us try to have some sort of activity po. Isosolve po natin yung primary classification. But by this time, you are the one solving it. So ngayon, I want you to practice. I want you to solve this primary classification by yourself. Mag-practice muna tayo. You practice yourself and check kung tama po ba kayo. So, ang gagawin po natin, may illustration po ako sa board. All you have to do is to get the primary classification. Ipo-post mo muna yung video mo. And then, pag may sagot na po kayo, play your video again because we will answer it together. I-check mo kung tama po ba yung sagot mo. Okay? So, ito po yung gagawin nyo. Okay, try to get the primary classification of this. Okay? So, finger number 1, ulnar. Finger number 2, tented. Finger number 3, plain whorl. Finger number 4, central packet loop. Finger number 5, double loop. Finger number 6, accidental, finger number 2, plain arch, finger number, finger number 7, I'm sorry, plain arch, finger number 8, accidental, finger number 9, ulnar, finger number 10, radial po. Again, all you have to do is to get the primary classification. Okay? So, pause your video now. Okay. So, i-check na natin yung primary classification nyo po. I-check natin kung tama ho ba yung sagot nyo po. Okay? Finger number 2, tented arch, 0. Okay? Hindi po natin magamit yan. Next, finger number 4. Finger number 4, 8. Since this is a whorl, kasi central pocket loop po siya, may 8 po tayo. Next, finger number 6. Finger number 6 is 4. Magamit din si 4 kasi whorl din po si accidental. Okay? So, plus 4. Next, finger number 8. Finger number 8 again is an accidental whorl. It has a numerical value of 2. Therefore, plus 2. Next, finger number 10. Radial, no numerical value. You cannot make use of that numerical value. 0. So therefore, 8 plus 4 equals 12. Plus 2, 14. Plus 1, 15. So therefore, yung primary classification mo for the numerator side is 15. Ngayon, I hope tama po yung numerator mo. Okay? Punta po tayo doon sa denominator. Add fingers. Finger number 1, 0. Tama po ba? Kasi ulnar to. Next, finger number 3. 8, kasi whorl to. So, magagamit natin si 8. Okay? So, you have 8. Next, finger number 5. Finger number 5 is double loop. Whorl din to. So, magamit natin si 4. So, plus 4. Next, finger number 7. Arch. So, hindi na magamit natin si 2. Kasi arch yan. Next, finger number 9. Finger number 9 is ulnar. Non-whorl. Walang numerical value. So therefore, 8 plus 4 equals 12 plus 1 equals 13. Therefore, yung answer nyo po must be 15 over 30. I hope na tama po yung pag-practice mo. Pag hindi po tama guys, then practice more. Okay? So, guys, I hope na naiintindihan nyo po yung primary classification po. I hope na nasimplify po natin yung explanation po ng primary classification. Okay, watch out for our next video. Pag-uusapan po natin si secondary classification at saka si sub-secondary classification. Okay, for now, yan lang muna guys. Hanggat sa muli po again, I would like to invite you to please do subscribe in my YouTube channel, Ed Montalba po, and please follow me in my Facebook account, Edwin Taganas Montalba FB page. Ingat po. God bless you all.